What's going on, everybody? It is I, Strix, back at it with more Marvel Snap, and today I'm playing with the Big G himself. It's my Galactus deck. This is my Galactus deck pre-update. So some of the things here you might see, like Alioth and other things, this is before the update took into effect. So I just wanted to make note of that. But this is not only featuring Galactus, but also featuring one of the newer cards herself, Martyr, the 1/4 card, series, three. Her ability is, if at the very end of the game, she moves to a location that loses you the game if possible. So kind of a different version of Captain Marvel. Apparently, in the lore, she's also been known as Captain Marvel. So what I've done is I've used her I put her into the Galactus deck as somewhat of a prio card. Like, okay, she's there to help me gain priority as a strong 1/4 card early on, and that way I get priority across the field, and then after I destroy locations, I don't have to worry about her ability. So that's the general gist of the idea behind this deck. I like the way that I have that played out, so let's keep going. So a lot of things happened already. So let's see. Bucky's over there. There's Venom. So they're trying to create some plays over here. I see you. Trying your best. So he's got Wolverine and X-23, which is going to be problematic, because if I destroy them utilizing Galactus, they might come back. But I think we have some plays here. I'm going to put Hobgob over in Jutunheim. Oh, he's putting Nova there. Perfect. Oh, the stage is set for my victory. For you see, Jutunheim is locked in. It is turn 6, which means Galactus is going to come into play. Oh, there they go. Yes. Here's the best part, ladies and gentlemen. Galactus destroys Jutunheim. He loses because not only is it locked location, normally X-23 and Wolverine would come back and jump to the location, but because it's full, there's no room for him. Permanently destroying Wolverine. And X-23, don't forget her too. But most importantly, Wolverine. Ooh, yes. That felt nice. That felt devious, devastating. Other words. It just felt good. That's what it felt. It felt good. Yeah, that's the general idea. So yeah. Playing Martyr in a Galactus deck, it's just, it acts kind of like, I've had versions of this deck that had, Ebony Maw. Ebony Maw is an early prio card. I have had with Zero and other cards in there. Martyr's pretty much the same. I like having Martyr here because she doesn't have any, like, weird quirks until the very end, which is the most important part. And it looks like my opponent's retreating because they saw the onslaught of Martyrs coming their way. So, you know, good choice. Ugh, oh, excuse me. Pray! Let's see what you got, buddy. Also in this deck, I do have Uatu. Uatu's here because he acts as a, a seer into the future. So that way I can plan my my plays accordingly. So that way, I based on like what I need to do, I'm going to put them on the field. So I'm going to put Forge down. And let's see. Ooh, the TVA. Okay. Let's see. Let's put Lizardo over in a negative zone. I'm going to use Forge to buff him up over there so that way he gets prio on that side. All right. Turn 3. All right. Monster Metropolis is here. I'm going to put Nakia down to buff up everybody in my hand. This is important so that way Galactus can stand. Gladiator. Let's see what he pulls. Oh! He pulled Wave! Okay. I mean, he destroys Wave, but Wave uses her ability. And we can use that and abuse that, ladies and gentlemen. And that's exactly what I do. Oh, you're playing Death? Well, guess what? Death means nothing to Galactus! Oh. Yes, I am a toxic Galactus player. And I'm damn proud of it. Oh, you definitely did not see that coming. That was, you know, it's his fault. He summoned Wave with Gladiator. So, yeah. Yeah. How you again?